Panchakoti is 5 crore. Shivanama is the Panchakshari, Shiva Panchakshari mantra, Om Namah Shivaya. All of us have gathered here together to chant 5 crore Shivanama at our own time, at our own convenience, individually or in a group. I welcome all of you for this Panchakoti Shivanama Japayadna. Next slide, please. When we say Shiva, change the slide, please. When we say Shiva, the first thing that comes to our mind is Shiva Linga. The Linga means symbol. The Shiva Linga, for example, Pullinga means masculine gender. Strilinga means feminine gender. Linga means indicator. What does it indicate? The infinite consciousness, which is formless, is indicated by the Shiva, Shivalinga, the top. And the nature, Prakriti, which is manifestation, is indicated by the base. Shivalinga is indication of the totality of existence. So Shivalinga, Shiva, the formless consciousness, is shown through Shivalinga. Next slide, please. And also when we speak of Shiva, we remember a person, a yogi sitting in Kailasa. It's called Shiva Yogi. Shivalinga is formless reality. And the one who has realized Shiva consciousness in him is called Shiva Yogi. The first Shiva Yogi is called Adi Yogi, who lived in Himalayas. Anybody who realizes Shiva consciousness in him is Shiva Yogi. If you realize Shiva consciousness in you, you become Shiva Yogi. And how do you realize Shiva consciousness? By realizing the truth. Nanu, nanembudu, nanalla, ideha, manabuddhi, nanalla, sachidanandatma, shivananu nane, shivoham, shivoham, shivoham is the way to realize the inner consciousness, Shiva. Then you are Shiva Yogi. So we are speaking of Shiva Yogi sitting in Himalayas, who is the Adi Yogi, the first yogi. And the first yogi taught the science of realization in terms of Shiva Sutra, in terms of many practices. Everything in Shiva Yogi's form is a yogic symbol. For example, there's a jata, the matted lock. Matted lock tells us to concentrate just above the head for Sahasrara. And Adna Chakra indicates to us, focus here on the Adna center. The serpent here indicates the ego has to be mastered. Like that, every symbol of Shiva is a yogic symbol for us to meditate. We'll get into details in the days to come. But now, please understand, the Shiva, Adi Yogi, is a representation of a yogi. And the form of Shiva is there to meditate. The moon on the head of Shiva represents, the moon should be an ornament, not a burden. The Trishula indicates that jnana, which can destroy three types of ignorance. Adi bhutika, adi daivika, adhyatmika. Three types of suffering is destroyed. So like that, every aspect of Shiva Yogi is a symbol for us to understand some higher truths. Next slide, please. So the entire journey of spirituality is the oneness of Shiva and Shakti. That's why Shiva is represented as Ardhanarishwar. The consciousness which is unchanging is shown as Shiva. The changing consciousness, changing manifest world is the Shakti. The consciousness and energy together create this entire universe. So we have to understand the union of Shiva and Shakti. That's called realization. The Shiva and Shakti, let's say whatever I see, experience, feel, touch, all these things belong to the category of manifest world. That's Shakti. The mountain, the sun, the stars, planets, galaxies, everything is Shakti. The river, water, our thoughts, feelings, emotions, our body, mind, intellect is Shakti, Prakriti. And the one who sees this is Shiva, consciousness. Now the Shiva and Shakti are separated by Jiva. The Jiva is me, the ego, the thought. I feel this world is separate from me. I feel consciousness is separate from me. So there's a feeling of separation. So this Jiva has to merge with Shiva and Shakti. That's where you realize the total oneness, the subjective reality and objective reality is one. The one reality, non-dual reality, Advaita Satya, that we call as Shiva Shakti Rupine Namaha. Om Shiva Shakti Rupine Namaha. Om Shiva Shakti Rupine Namaha. Om Shiva Shakti Rupine Namaha. Shiva and Shakti has to become one. The Jiva has to merge with the Shiva and Shakti. So the entire spiritual journey of Shiva Sadhana is to realize oneness of Shiva and Shakti and merge Shiva, merge Jiva in Shiva. Next slide, please. So now let us look at the Om Namah Shivaya mantra. The Om Namah Shivaya is called Shiva Panchakshari. Namah Shivaya. Five letters, five alphabets. Om is the primordial sound. So these five alphabets represent many things in creation. The five elements of nature, the space, the wind, the fire, the water, and earth, these are five elements. These five elements are represented by Om Namah Shivaya. That means Om Namah Shivaya represents Shakti also. So the five elements is the outer nature. Five elements, five aspects of our body is called pancha koshas, annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha. Our body has five aspects. We have five indriyas, pancha indriyas. Eyes, ears, nose, touch, tongue, smell, taste. Like that, five sense organs, five organs of actions are there. Everything is five in nature. That five is represented by Panchakshari mantra. So then, the sensing of the world is done through five sensations: touch, sound, smell, taste, form. Okay, these are five sensations. So everything is represented by Shiva Panchakshari mantra. Panchakshari is five. Five represents five aksharam, five manifest reality, which is nothing but Shakti. So Shiva Panchakshari mantra is a muktidayaka mantra. It's mantra for liberation. It's a mantra for self-realization. Who is Shiva here? Shiva is the pure consciousness. And the Shakti is the entire manifest universe. When we ignore the name and form, the Shakti becomes one with Shiva. So that is called Advaita Siddhi, Advaita Sadhana. That's called Mukti. Next slide, please. So let us now understand how we can connect with Shiva. How we can connect Shiva and Shakti, one realization, oneness realization. We have three centers, the heart center, the head center. Heart center is called Manas and head center is called Buddhi. Heart center is our lower self, emotions, feelings, thoughts, subconscious impressions, vasanas, all those things come up. The head center is the intellect. Now, the intellect reflects the consciousness and the reflected consciousness becomes Jiva. So now we have to integrate our buddhi, manas, with the higher consciousness, atma, paramatma. So now when we integrate this, there's oneness. And that oneness is called self-realization or mukti. Let us understand how to do it. Stop the slides, please. So our lower center is emotions, feelings, thoughts. Our higher center is buddhi. And overall, everything in the universe is Shiva, Paramatma. So now we have to unite Jivatma with Paramatma. That's Panchakshari mantra is all about. Panchakshari mantra is Mukti mantra. It is mantra for liberation, Jiva Mukti. Shiva in Panchakshari mantra refers to Atma, Atma Shiva. So let us understand how to chant Panchakshari mantra. First, Panchakshari mantra starts with Omkara. Any mantra starts with Omkara. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namo Narayana, Om Namo Bhagavati Vasudevaya. The Omkara is not just a sound. It's a method of connecting with a higher consciousness. It's a switch, it's a mobile connection. So when we chant Omkara, our energies connect with the universal energy, Shakti. So that way, there's a purification happens within us. So let us chant. Let us understand how to chant Omkara so that we can connect with the universal energy. The universal energy we can connect at a distance from here, from the our eyesight, or at the top of the head, Sahasrara, just about 10, 12 inches. That's where the Shiva's Jata, the matted lock, is there. Or Shiva's third eye, both can be used to connect with the universal energy, Shakti. So let us chant Akara, Ukara, Makara. When we chant Akara, the vibration starts from the Nabi, navel center. It Akara, vibrations have to rise all the way up to Adna, so that your lower center gets connected to higher center. Then you chant Ukara, vibration starts from heart center, connect to the Adna. Then when you chant Makara, the vibrations happens in the brain and nervous system. So that way we are connecting our lower center and higher center, the head and heart. Then through Omkara, we connect it to the cosmic energy. Is that simple? Let us chant now Akara, Ukara, Makara. When you chant Akara, let the vibration start at the Nabi, the navel center. You have to learn how to put lock. This lock is called Shambhavi Mudra. When you just look at your eyes, just gently, two eyes, as if you're looking at a kumkum here, the mind becomes silent. So that point is called third eye. Third eye is the place where your left brain and right brain meet, the head and heart meet. Okay, there's a balance happens, masculine and feminine. So by that, mind calms down and our intuition gets activated. First, put a Shambhavi Mudra, the eye lock. Gently take your attention to the forehead center and feel the energy there. Immediately, the mind calms down. The left brain and right brain gets balanced. The masculine and feminine energies get balanced. Shiva Shakti gets balanced. So start chanting Akara. Retain the eye lock. Then hold your hands in this form. This is called Chin Mudra. Okay. So hold your hands in Chin Mudra and keep it on your lap. Let us start chanting Akara from the Nabi. The vibrations come all the way up to Adna. Now chant Ukara from the heart center. Ukara, heart center. Nabi is your center for energy, Kriya Shakti. Ukara is your center for emotions. Let the emotion center get purified by chanting Ukara. Chant Ukara from the heart center, connecting with the Adna Chakra. Now your Nabi and Anahata, Manipura and Anahata are connected to Adna through chanting Akara, Ukara. Now chant Makara so that your entire nervous system gets energized, brain and nervous system. Now visualize you are chanting Om mantra, starting from Adna, it'll go into the outer space. You should look as if you are looking upwards. Let the energy move at about 12 inches or 14 inches. The individual energy merges with the universal energy. Omkara will connect you with the individual energy, with the universal energy. It's like a pipe, mobile connection. You should be looking slightly upwards. Om. 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 Now with your eyes there, Shiva's third eye, you feel connected with the universal energy, Shakti. Let the pull be there. Now let us chant Om Namah Shivaya. When you chant Om Namah Shivaya, Omkara will connect with the universal energy, Shakti. Omkara is a switch. It's like a mobile connection. Once you connect to Omkara, then Namah Shivaya will chant. Namah Shivaya is the message. So what we are saying is Namah Shivaya. Na means earth. Ma means water. Shi means wind. Va means Ashi means fire, Va means wind, Ya means space. So all the five elements, Akasha, Vayu, Jala, Agni, Prithvi, we are saying is nothing other than Shiva. We are speaking of Shakti is nothing but Shiva. Let us chant Om Namah Shivaya. With that understanding, with our eyes looking slightly upwards and be aware of the vibration in the heart and lower centers. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. We are saying the space, the wind, the fire, the water is nothing but Shiva. Shiva is my self, my inner self, Atma. Atma only appearing as the total world. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Like that, you can chant. So now, by this chanting process, you are saying the objective world is nothing but Shiva. Shiva is myself. Then you can bring your attention into yourself. Outer world is Shiva. Now you see inner world. Inner world consisting of five koshas. So when you chant, you can chant a couple of rounds with the outer world as Shiva. Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Jala, Prithvi, Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. The space is Shiva, the wind is Shiva, the fire is Shiva, water is Shiva, earth is Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Everything is Shiva. Shiva only is there. Now we'll take your attention to your five koshas, your body. Pancha koshas. Physical body, Annamaya kosha. Om Namah Shivaya. Feel the vibration throughout the body when you chant. Om Namah Shivaya. Vibration starting from the heart center. Om Namah Shivaya. Then go to Pranamaya Kosha, the energy body. Chant Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Energy body is nothing but Shiva. Then Manomaya Kosha, mental body, thoughts, feelings, emotions. Everything is Shiva only. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Then you take your attention to intellectual body, ideas, thinking. Shiva only. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Now we'll take to our thought process, our attention to the Mooladhara Chakra, the base, six chakras are there. Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha. From the base of the spine, all the way up to throat. Then come Omkara. So when you chant Omkara, your attention should be in the Adna. the forehead center.
Om.
Then Namah Shivaya. From the base of the spine, the energy should move upwards into Adna. Adna is Omkara.
Om.
Namah Shivaya. Energy moves from the base of the spine to the Adna.
Om. Namah Shivaya.
So from base of the spine to all the way to Adna. Second time when you say, it's from upward movements. Second time, the downward movements. From the Adna to down.
Om. Namah Shivaya.
Here, Na starts with the Vishuddhi. Ma starts with the Mars Anahata. Like that, here ends with the Muladhara. So, upward movement is called Arohana. Downward movement is called Avarohana.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Upward movement.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Downward movement. Arohana and Avarohana.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
This like this. Arohana, Avarohana. So now you take your attention to the top of the head. Sahasrara. Just above the Shiva's matted hair. About 12 inches from the top of the head. Stay there. Silent. That's actually called Paramashiva or Supreme Reality. Parabrahma, Paramashiva. Stay there. The mind becomes silent as if you are looking upwards at that center. Then again come back. Shiva and Shakti have to become one in the body in the Ardhachakra. Then you have to go to Parashiva, which is slightly above the head. So this is what the meaning of Shiva's matted lock. Third eye of Shiva is the place where Shiva and Shakti become one. So after going staying there for some time, come down to Adna Chakra.
Om.
Again, start from the base of the spine.
Namah Shivaya.
Again, Om. From Arohana to Avarohana.
Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
So the vibration starts the Sahasrara Chakra, energy center, and top. Stay there. So you can chant the mantra for Panchabhutas, Panchakoshas, five chakras, bring the attention to Adna. Or you can go to Sahasrara above, where is the abode of Paramashiva, where Shiva and Shakti have become one, Parameshwara. So like that, you can do Japa Sadhana. Now, what is the benefit of doing this Japa Sadhana? When the outer world and inner world, outer world consists of Panchabhutas, Panchakoshas, Panchatanmatra, Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasaganda, all those things are nothing but Shiva. The consciousness in the moment is Shakti. What appears as matter is nothing but Shiva. So we remember that. Then take our attention to Adna, where Shiva and Shakti become one. And beyond Adna, at the Sahasrara, Paramashiva is there, where Shiva and Shakti are in silent mode. So this is the sadhana. When you chant outside, the chanting outside is called, in the gross world, is called Virat Purusha, Vishwa. And the inner world, when you chant the spinal cord, nervous system, it's called Hiranyagarbha. At the chanting, the Hiranyagarbha, the Virat Purusha chanting and Hiranyagarbha chanting, lot of karma gets cleared. When you chant Virat Purusha, outer gross world also karma gets cleared. When you chant inwards, then also karma gets cleared. But the effect is much more in the inners, inside, when the inside chanting. You can visualize the spinal cord as a bead. Japamala, Muladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha, and again reverse. So like that when you do chanting, it's called Hiranyagarbha level. So what is the import of Hiranyagarbha is, we have an outer world, gross world. The gross world, sunrise, the sun, earth moves around the sun once in 365 days a year. That means 1 year. Then when you do internal japa, the internal japa is Atma Surya. That moves from Mooladhara to Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Adna, and reverse way. So that is actually is considered 1 year. So the inner 1 year japa is equal to inner japa of one round is equal to 1 year of sadhana outside. So in that way, our karma gets burnt much faster. And this is actually called the centers are called Bhuloka, Bhuvaloka, Suvarloka, Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Satyaloka. So these are centers correspond to higher level lokas. So we do sadhana at the higher level loka, there's much more purification. So you can start from outer, you can start going inwards, and then you can stay at the Sahasrara. Sahasrara is called Parashivaloka, Parabrahmaloka. So the karma getting cleared much more at the Parameshwara Loka. So like that, Shiva, Om Namah Shivaya Japa is for purification. When you stay at the Sahasrara, it's called meditation. And that Sahasrara, you have to mentally chant Shivoham, I am Shiva. So you have started with the five kosha, space, wind, fire, water, as Shiva. Pancha Bhutasa Shiva, Pancha Kosha says Shiva, Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Shiva, Anandamaya Kosha. Then you have done five chakras, Muladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha, connected to Shiva. So then you have gone to Sahasrara, where you have to remember your true nature, Shivoham, I am Shiva, and sit silently. If thoughts come, again, I am Shivoham, and go back to Sahasrara. So this is how the entire practice, it involves chanting, it involves meditation. So meditation you can do only at the end of several rounds of chanting. The energy, let the energy within and without, inside and outside get merged. Then after that, sitting silently in meditation. Om Namah Shivaya. That is the meditation. Ashivoham is the meditation. So this is the entire journey. Om Namah Shivaya. And ending up in meditation called Shivoham. So this mantra, Shivoham means Shiva means self. Everything is self. Everything is Atma. Everything is Atma Shiva. The world, the body, mind, intellect, everything is Atma Shiva. It's called Om Namah Shivaya. Then gradually, gently open your eyes. Is the procedure clear to all? Anybody has any questions? You can ask. Not seven rounds.
You said several rounds.
Okay.
We heard seven rounds.
Okay.
No, seven rounds.
Okay.
So you can do 10 rounds, 20 rounds outside.
Ten rounds.
Inside. Oh. Right? It is no, there's no limit. It's ultimately your mind has to go from outer to inner, no?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, Guruji.
Mind has to travel from outer to inner.
Yes, Guruji. Thank you.
Anybody any questions?
Ashwini here, Guruji.
Ashwini, yeah.
Can you please explain Avarohana once again?
There is Arohana and Avarohana, right?
Hmm.
Always it starts with Omkara. When you sit at Omkara, it's with Atna Chakra.
Hmm.
Okay. So then Arohana means rising from Muladhara, basal spine, Manipura, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha, Adna, like that it will go. Arohana. Arohana means rise.
Hmm.
So you can say it's called Uttarayana. The sun moving northwards.
Hmm.
It's actually exactly corresponds to the physical sun moving northwards. Physical sun northwards moves in the gross plane. This is in the subtle plane. Subtle plane is much more effective.
Okay.
Right? So any sadhana you do in the inner plane is 365 times more effective than the outer sadhana. Because outer sadhana, you require 365 days to cover one round of a movement. In the inner sadhana, you need one round of japa. So that means your action, your karmic burning, karmic impressions will get burnt 365 times faster in the inner circle.
Okay.
So the avarohana is coming down. Om at the
Mm-hmm.
Na, throat center, ma in the heart center, shi vaya to the base of the spine.
Okay.
Right? So this one cycle. So then sometimes after this energy is balanced, then you can go above Sahasrara. Stay there in the Shivaloka or Parashivaloka. There you have to chant Shivoham. I am Shiva. You have to become one with Shiva. You don't keep on chanting I'm Shiva. Shivoham, you remember, sit silently. If thoughts come, again Shivoham. Then if you are not able to stay there, come down. Again, Adna, Arohana, Avarohana. Is it clear? It's like climbing a mountain. So when you are climbing a mountain, you'll go up to certain line. Then if you are able to go above, stay there. If you cannot stay, come down again.
Okay.
Anybody else, any questions?
Understood.
Hari Om, Guruji.
Hari Om.
Maitreyi here.
Yes, Maitreyi.
ಇದು ನಮ ಶಿವಾಯ ಹೀಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರೈಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಆರೋಹಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರೋಹಣದಲ್ಲೂ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಅದು ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್.
ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳಿ, ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ ನಿಧಾನ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನಮ ಶಿವಾಯ, ಬಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಗೋ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡು ನಮ ಶಿವ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಯು ಡು, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಮ ಶಿವಾಯ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ರೈಟ್? ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸ್ಲೋ ಡೌನ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡು ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್. But when you do sitting individual chanting, you can do slowly.
Okay.
And after chanting should be always, in a group chanting, everybody should hear Om Namah Shivaya. Together people should do, right? But when you sit at home, chant for yourself, your chanting should be Om Namah Shivaya. Only what you can hear. Om Namah Shivaya. It's not mental chanting. It should be verbal. Om Namah Shivaya. Right? And you can use beads, you can use Rudrakshmala, you can use the electronic counter. Is it clear to all?
Prabhuji?
Yes.
Hari Om, Prabhuji.
Yes.
Prabhuji, you told us Sahasrara we should do some meditation. So which meditation should we do, Prabhuji?
No meditation. Sit silently. When you go to Sahasrara, you have become one with Shiva. You are merged with Shiva.
Okay, Prabhuji.
Right? But if you get thoughts, then you say Shivoham and sit silently again.
Okay, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, and should we divide? So we tell 108 times, right, in the beads. So Prabhuji, should we for Mooladhara these many times and Sahasrara these many times? Should we divide?
No. It's up to you. See, it's up to you, because when the mind is outwards, you chant more outwards. When the mind goes inwards, you chant more inwards. Like that, it's you have to get a feel.
Okay, Prabhuji. Thank you.
There's no hard and fast rule.
Okay.
Right? Okay, next.
Hari Om, Guruji. Nan Kalyani maatadta idene.
Hari Om, Kalyani amma, heli.
Adu ivaga mooladharadinda Om Namah Shivaya Agnya Chakrakke bandmele matte Sahasrarakke yav tara navu id maadkobeku?
Avana hobeku ashte. Your attention should go ashte.
Oh.
Al chanting illa. There's no chanting. Your attention should go. ಲೈಕ್ ಶಿವ ಸಿಮೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಹೇರ್, ಶಿವನ್ ತಲೆ ಜಟೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ತುದಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆ ಗಮನ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆ ಮೇಲೆ
ಆಜ್ಞಾ ಚಕ್ರ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು.
ಗಮನ ಅಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾತ್ರ,
ಗಮನ ಆಜ್ಞಾ ಚಕ್ರ ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಸತಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಇದೆ
ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಅದು ಧ್ಯಾನ. ಅದು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಸತಿ. ಸಿ, ಧ್ಯಾನ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮನ್ಸು ಪುನಃ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಮೈಂಡ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ನೌ, ದೆನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಡೌನ್ ಅಗೈನ್.
ಸರಿ,
ರೈಟ್? Stay as long as possible. If you cannot stay, come down.
Sir.
Right? But this you do Sahasrara Dhyana only at the end of the meditation. Let's say you are doing 108 round chanting. So only last 10 rounds you do that Sahasrara Dhyana. Otherwise it's due to chanting, energy movements. Initially you just balance the energy. Then last 10 rounds you do that and stay there.
One night aad mele navu sahasrara adu meditation madbeku.
Haudu, amel kutkobe silent aagi.
ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ ಶಿವೋಹಂ
ಮತ್ತೆ ಶಿವೋಹಂ ಶಿವಂ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬಂದು ಪಾದ
ಅದೇ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು
ರೈಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಶಿವೋಹಂ ಐ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಶಿವ
ಹರಿ ಓಂ ಗುರುಜಿ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆರೋಹಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆರೋಹಣ ಒಂದು ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆ ತರನ ಗುರುಜಿ
ಓಂ ನಮಃ ಶಿವಾಯ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕೌಂಟ್
ಓ ಓಕೆ ಗುರುಜಿ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಓಂ ನಮಃ ಶಿವಾಯ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕೌಂಟ್
ಓಕೆ
ರೈಟ್ ನೌ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಶಲ್ ವಿ ಡು ಒನ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್
ಈಗ ಆರೋಹಣ ಒಂದ್ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಅವರೋಹಣ ಒಂದ್ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ
ಹೌದು
ಎರಡು ಕೌಂಟ್
ಆಗುತ್ತೆ
ಸರಿ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಓಕೆ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ನೌ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ದ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಗೈಡೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್